It's the NFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports.
One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. They're going to mark that where it went out of bounds, so really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
Automatic first down.
Cousins on first down. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
And four at their 48-yard line.
They go play action. Cousins. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. But now it's third down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. There he goes, left side. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. Why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change.
23-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They trail here early in this division round game as they seek a spot in the NFC title bout. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge.
Jefferson.
The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Second and 10.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Cousins to throw it. Setting up the screen for Cook. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Second down pass play got them 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. A first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of 2. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Vikings first down.
Now a run with Cook. It's up to about the 37. He's calling a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. From the 37, they work on second and 6. A give to Cook out of the gun. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. To throw again on second down, Cousins. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there, and it's third down. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football, and the Cowboys have recovered. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Prescott down. Flushed out right. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. CeeDee Lamb. 40 yards. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Well, what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs. If you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you talk about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you've got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this one PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
And it's good to make it 14-0.
Makes the score Cowboys 14, Vikings nothing.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football.
Tyrone Crawford. Kirk Cousins sacked.
Second time in this game, Charles, the ball has squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled?
And he finally goes out of bounds across the opposite 40.
Take over first and 10.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Now Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Prescott looks to throw on first. And this is caught. It's Cooper. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys will extend their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Getting ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack.
Three scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
So we've come upon halftime here in this. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it.
Vikings nothing.
A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. This is Tony Pollard. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 32.
Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10, right at the 40. Elliott. And some room to maneuver. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
They'll run on first down. Elliott fighting through, and he's got space. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 25 yards. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead.
Apparently, the week off hasn't hurt him one bit. 1,000-yard rush in the regular season. Got his first touchdown here in the playoffs. Perhaps the week off energized him.
A great article in the paper this morning basically saying that they would not have won the division without him. And he's not their only piece, but I think that's a fair statement.
It's easy to say it this way. He's their main cog.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And this will make it into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mild, though, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
It's a gain of a yard, and it's third down.
On third down, Cousins. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They get only 4 that time, as that leads us to a fourth down. 1 quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Tyrone Crawford in there to get him yet again. That is his third sack tonight. They can't figure him out. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys, and they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. Dancing to his left. He's going to take off with him. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Eric Kendricks in on the tackle. It's a gain of 6. Makes it 3rd and 4.
On 3rd down, Elliott. He'll have a 1st down inside the 10. And all the way down to the 5. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on 3rd and medium. Proved to be the right call. 1st and 10. And they've got 3 tight ends here on 1st and goal to add some extra mass. Elliott. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
And the Vikings now heading on to the field. Now they knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Call that a very strong gain of 24. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
Greg Zuerlein lining up.
That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it. Back to it after the pick six. Cousin. Incomplete. Right side. The tight end Rudolph. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Brings up second.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. And the Cowboys will advance to the next round as we say thanks for watching and so long, everybody. For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL.